So I agree with Matt with the national carry, of course. You know, you can't, you know, if you're going to cross state lines and be a felon in one state, and especially inadvertently like we have in New Hampshire where we're so, we border so many areas and we're such a small state. But to the point with the question that you asked, you know, when you purchase a product, because that goes into fining and taxing as well, right?
It does.
Yes. So when you purchase a piece of ammunition or a gun or whatever, you know, in one state, and it's more overly restrictive in another state, then you're going to have everybody flocking to one place where they can get everything, you know, without having the taxes or the restrictions, and then you're not going to be able to get it across the states, and so. I would support a national law that levels the playing field, makes it all equal, and I do believe in the 10th Amendment, I believe in the states' rights, but the Second Amendment is not is not up for grabs for states' rights. It's codified, we have it as a Second Amendment, you know, as an ability to be able to keep and bear arms and not have the states infringe upon that. And so I would support a national, such a law nationally.
Lynn, thank you. Steve?
I'm good. That's a tough question because, again, I'm not a big federal government guy. And even though in spirit I believe that you should be able to go across state lines, the states have a right to determine what it is that they want to do with their firearms. What's interesting to note is right now in Ann Kuster's committee, there's a bill called House Resolution 5717. And what she's proposing is that there is a 50% sales tax on all ammunition, federal sales tax, a 30% sales tax on all guns and long rifles, and a national registry for gun owners that's retroactive. We saw what happened in New York, and I wrote an op-ed that ran in the paper, is that they took everybody that was on that registry and published their names in the newspaper, so that everybody knew who had a weapon and who didn't have a weapon. This is the congresswoman that we have. You know, this great state of New Hampshire is an amazing state because we're law-abiding gun owners, and that's the way we want to keep it. So this RSA is here for a purpose. If that RSA needs to change, it's got to go through our House and our Senate. But we have a federal congresswoman that's trying to enact a federal law that will overreach and usurp this RSA because that's what she wants, that's what those gun grabbers want to do. You got to think very long and hard what's going to happen on both September 8th and November 3rd. The reason why this state is so great is because we know what our responsibilities are. Don't let the government tell us what I can and can't do with my weapons. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. Eli?